our expectation of enjoyment is a little different right now than it would be off of Ivy's. Really? Why?
Why?
What?
Why did I think that was where I should put the camera?
Hey, it's a good shot.
Right there on the radiator.
Good morning, guys. Oh, Ollie wants to come say good morning. Say good morning to the...
Okay, the camera died. We're back. We're back at it.
Back at you. Here on Saturday.
Do you want to come join us?
Come here. Did you eat your dinner yet?
You gonna eat your dinner?
I gave you special treats in your dinner.
Oh.
Ollie sometimes forgets to eat his dinner, so we have to give incentives sometimes.
Like if I give him a treat right now, it would remind him, oh, I'm hungry, and then he goes and eats. It's just like me. He and I are very similar in
you
that way.
You two are silly.
You should open up the package you got today.
Yes.
He surprised me. I didn't know he ordered this.
I ordered a Let's Do This t-shirt.
This is our first time seeing it in person.
We made these while Mary was in the hospital. Obviously, Mary and I made our own versions right before her surgery, but we wanted to make t-shirts for you guys, and we ordered one for us, and...
What's the other one?
I'm gonna try it on. It's the same thing.
Oh, cool. That's fun. Did you guys get your t-shirts yet? I have a couple friends who ordered them and they got them, but I haven't seen you guys. I don't think, I should check. Where's my phone? Let me check on, looks awesome, babe.
Let's do this. And then,
oh,
the Fry Life.
That's the first time we've printed on a sleeve before.
I like it.
I think it's really cool.
Really cool.
Aww. So I love it.
We hope that these t-shirts can be a cheering for you kind of thing. Let's do this.
Well, and for me, it was like a pump up thing.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, let's do this.
Have you guys ever seen the New Zealand rugby team? They
no.
do the, it's called, they call it the haka or something.
Oh, you guys used to do
this.
Yeah,
we would do it
in college
for intramural things. But it's like, and they like do this little,
and then
like
choo, choo,
yeah.
Choo, choo.
Yeah.
It's like, yes.
It's like the Macho Macarena.
Okay, there you go. Okay, I wanted to see if we were tagged or
anybody's
anything.
Posted.
I don't think so. I'm so excited to see them.
All right, if you guys have a Let's Do This t-shirt, be sure to tag us or our store Instagram, and we'd love to see them. And our store Instagram, The Fry Life, features
Fry Life.
Your guys' post
yeah.
When we see those on the internet.
Yeah.
Isn't that right, Bonesy?
So we just heard back from the doctors. We were wondering, I don't know, I guess so. I had labs on Thursday and I don't think we updated you guys. My numbers are coming down, which we expected. That was expected, but maybe they're coming down a little faster than we thought they would. But we were just wondering, we were actually like about to get in the car and drive to Boston today to potentially go get blood work again. But we were waiting to hear back. Is it necessary? Should we, shouldn't we?
Because the plan was, and still is, that we'll get blood work next on Monday. But today, as we were thinking about how her numbers were, like the pattern they were following, we were starting to wonder, are they dropping more than, like, will 4 days between blood draws
be too much?
Be too much time for us to... Basically, if they're getting too low, either we do something about those blood counts, do another Neupogen shot or something, or we stop drugs because the drugs are gonna suppress her blood, marrow, and all of that. So it puts us in a tricky spot. But she talked to somebody at the hospital.
Ollie, he's having fun destroying this toy skunk.
Set, go get it.
I talked to the pulmonary fellow on call and she looked at the numbers, and she looked at the note from my team and everything, and she said, looks like you're good to wait till Sunday. Because when I talked to the lab person today, they were like, you could come tomorrow. And I was like, tomorrow's my birthday. And she was like, oh, happy birthday. She was really sweet, but yeah, so ultimately I'm really thankful that we didn't have to go in and get labs again today, just because that would have been a couple hours of driving. And I did end up taking my nausea meds and Tylenol before my afternoon dose, and that helped so much, because yesterday I ended up feeling so bad in the afternoon, and then into the evening I just really wasn't feeling good. Ended up with a pretty bad headache last night. So we're pretty sure that all of those, the headaches and stuff that I've been having for the last like 2 weeks,
side effects of imipenem.
Yeah, pretty sure. I think that the headaches, like my original headaches that I had been having, the IV antibiotics kind of calm down the infection and therefore calm down those headaches. So that was already kind of taken care of. And then, sorry to all your dogs who are now looking for where the squeaky toy is. Anyway, so those headaches are under control for now, but now it's just the side effect headaches. I went outside for like 10 minutes today and worked on some of my flowers, like just pulling off the dead ones and stuff. And that was awesome, but so humid.
Yeah,
I was like,
ugh. It's been kind of, we had thunderstorms this afternoon, and it was like all around our house. It was like boom.
It was kind of magical.
Yeah, we liked it, but
we ate baked potatoes.
We are riveting. I think part of what is happening right now with this vlog and with our lives is our sleep is getting interrupted by IVs, and
it's like having a newborn.
Yeah, and I don't know, I think, what?
I was talking to my friend who is pregnant, and I was like, I forget exactly what we were talking about, but I was like, being pregnant and being on IVs, it's kind of similar. Like, you don't get a lot of sleep. I think it might have been when I was in the hospital, and I was like, you don't get a lot of sleep, but you get a cute baby at the end, and all I get is diarrhea. And we laughed. Oh my goodness.
That's funny.
Anyway, so
I think what I'm saying is we are in IV
survival
home
mode.
Hospital mode, yeah. Where we're just kind of surviving, and but we're more than surviving.
Yeah.
We're enjoying our days, but we're intentionally like not having riveting days.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm also getting ready for church tomorrow. Yeah. I'm preaching and all those details, and so we're both a little tired and just kind of low key today.
Yeah, and a little out of it. I mean, yeah, just a little. Yeah, like Peter said, like we are enjoying our days, but just we have an expectation. Our expectation of enjoyment is a little different right now than it would be off of IVs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
but
that's a good life lesson, is to adjust your expectations for whatever season you have to go through. And
yeah, so if it's the beginning of school, you're gonna be a little bit busier trying to figure out syllabi or what is it in high school? Like the beginning of high school, like,
I don't know, do you have syllabi in high school?
I don't know.
I don't know.
But just like figuring out classes or where your classes are, whatever, like you're kind of, that's kind of fun, like the beginning, the start of something is kind of fun, but your category for fun is a little bit different by the end of the year. You yeah. Like fun is like going out and I don't know. What are we talking about?
I don't know, but can I say that like a toy skunk for a dog I think is a very, very bad idea. Like we're just teaching him to go play with a skunk. I don't know.
I guess.
Sometimes I'm afraid.
What is that?
I think nighttime animals in general kind of freak me out. Like, I hate opossums, skunks. Like, sometimes when Ollie and I go out in the yard at night, I'm like, what if there was a skunk back there? And he gets sprayed.
But, like, for real.
Yeah, for real.
I think I would immediately give him a haircut so it's less hair.
Did your dog ever get sprayed?
No. Did yours?
I don't think so. I don't know. Mom, did Barnaby ever get sprayed? He would probably get sprayed if he had the opportunity.
He was a little jerk, wasn't he?
I wouldn't call him a jerk. He was just,
We're talking about a dog.
Yeah, he was a curious little Lhasa Apso.
Didn't he, like, pee on the clean clothes or something?
I think so.
I'd call that a jerk. Oh, man.
So
we're gonna keep doing what we need to do the next thing, and I hope that you guys can keep doing the next thing as well. I was just looking through on our Facebook page, I was reading through the private messages, and somebody was in the hospital, and she was showing me that, like, on her iPad, it was, like, all Fry Life videos, and I was, like, just, like, comforted for the fact that, you know, I get it. When I'm in the hospital, I'm binge watching stuff too. So I'm honored and thankful that in some small way we can be cheering you guys on for whatever you're going through. Maybe it's up through the night nursing a baby or whatever it is. So you guys keep going and let's do this.
Let's do it. And speaking of Facebook, this is like our little
powwow.
Go team. Go Fry Life. On our Facebook page, we posted a video on Facebook this week, and we're going to be doing some more of that in weeks to come, of just little kind of, we called this one an untold story of the Fry Life, because I told the story of a moment in this past hospital stay where I was a little queasy.
So if you've ever wondered if any of the medical stuff gets to us or gets to Peter, go over to our Facebook page and you can find out. But until then, we'll see you guys tomorrow. As always.
Good night. Hey, maybe that should be our new thing.
So we'll see you guys.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Oh yeah, so we'll see you tomorrow.
As always.
Good night. And then, of course, the one and only.
Ollie.
Oh, you got this skunk?
Are you snuggling with a skunk? You want to show the people? You want to show off? Oh, that's a nice skunk you got there. Good night, guys.